We excellent.
Hey, aguántale, aguanta ahorita hasta los 5 o los 6. Y ahí te. De ahí ya estás cansando. Aguántale, chico.
So we've already seen Gervonta Davis advanced counter-punching ability. And now here, beginning of round four, Leo Santa Cruz double and triple pumping with the jab.
Davis averages only 39 punches per round. He's very economical in his punches compared, of course, to Santa Cruz, who we've said sometimes throws upwards of 80, averages 85. But it's the ability to land for Davis, to land with power, that means something.
There, Santa Cruz digging to the body. Meanwhile, Davis looking for the angle for that uppercut.
You don't always see Davis in that kind of defensive posture that he's in with his hands really high.
Well, you're working with Floyd Mayweather, you better learn defense. And there's Santa Cruz through the right, and Davis now loading up again with the left. Left uppercut, right hook by Davis, but Santa Cruz still looking to establish the jab, but he's getting hit.
Oh, and those left hooks of Santa Cruz getting home.
An eruption from the crowd here at the Alamo Dome, this main event delivering already.
Is this the right strategy for Santa Cruz? He's getting some good work done, but he's taking power punches.
I got it.
You know what this feels like? When Diego Corrales walked in, we thought he would box against Jose Luis Castillo. He stood in the pocket and battled. At first, we thought it was a bad idea. Turned out to be a good idea. What will happen tonight?
If this fight turns into one-tenth, yeah, the fight of Corrales Castillo won, this is going to be an all-time classic.
Listen, I think Santa Cruz is doing a great job. I think he's doing the right thing. And most of these big fights, a lot of these fighters, they say, no, you know, I'm going to let him win the first half of the fight. I'm going to box. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. And then before you know it, you got half of the fight lost. So Santa Cruz doesn't want that. He wants to get in some rounds in and doing a fantastic job. Both in David and Santa Cruz, what a fight.
Under a minute left in the fourth, Davis walking down Santa Cruz. Davis has gone to the body with the right hook. We've seen the left uppercut. Santa Cruz stealing a glance at his corner. The high guard. There's that long range jab from Santa Cruz.
Well, you saw the jab and you saw there, that counter uppercut is just poised for Davis. And even when he doesn't throw it, you can see he's ready to throw it.
Double jab, then the left hand downstairs by Davis avoids those punches from Santa Cruz. And again, stabs Santa Cruz in the belly with the left. There's a jab to the midsection by Davis. Rounds are flying by here at the Alamo Dome. We are through four.
Gervonta Davis getting that straight left hand in. That's one of his big power punches. And Santa Cruz trying to counter off that. The uppercut of Davis has been a very, very important weapon. The right hook getting in there. But then here, he comes with that uppercut on the inside. I'll tell you what, Santa Cruz is taking some big punches from Davis, and he's hanging in there right now. Now, he did have his good offensive moments. He would land the uppercut on the inside. This is the difference. Santa Cruz is a pure combination puncher. Abner, you know that better than anybody.
Yes, he is, and he could be overwhelming. That could be overwhelming. That's why I said that Leo Santa Cruz should be the volume puncher in this fight to overwhelm a Tank Davis that's never seen that before.
Santa Cruz has thrown 241 punches to 160 for Davis. That's not surprising.
This is round number five. Davis leaning on his front foot, high guard, both of them, double triple jab by Santa Cruz as he tries to move forward. Davis moving to his left into the power alley of Santa Cruz.
Leo has to keep touching him with that jab, have Davis be thinking.
Davis crouching down. He'll